through a sliding glass window door that bounces the camera, and then I hold up a book and I say my utmost.
Oh, well, that's what we call professional in the old gypsy kind of way of doing it. I wasn't called a Jesus gypsy for nothing. In fact, just about everywhere I've gone in the world, and whenever I've been involved in helping other ministries, I don't usually come in at the end of their ministries. I come in at the ground level where it's like grunt time and do those things that no one else will do. Like recently I was helping a pastor friend of mine and opening a historic old church that was really kind of cool. But because they had, because it is old, and we had just put some sound equipment in there, somebody needed to spend the night there. So I got to sleep on hard pews. And I, you know, had the time and opportunity, so I enjoyed it. I spent probably a week sleeping in the church and working in the daytime and then sleeping at church at night, and it was kind of cool. It reminded me of when I went to Mexico and, as a missionary, and did the same thing, you know, slept in the church we were working on, which was, at that time, dirt floors. And then I slept on the mountaintop Monte Ore above it, and it was wonderful. But the same thing in the end of my life now, with all that I have here, is really simple things. I don't go in for buying all the latest, greatest, newest, most inventive things there are. I just like the little things that God allows me to buy at a used store and make it work somehow. Because sometimes God uses the foolish things of the world to confound the wise, and God knows He's got no bigger fool than I am, and maybe I might confound some wise. Or maybe He will from inside me to that person. In utmost, the spiritual saint, that I may know him, Philippians 3:10. The initiative of the saint is not towards self-realization, but towards knowing Jesus Christ. The spiritual saint never believes circumstances to be haphazard, or thinks of his life as a secular and sacred. He sees everything he is dumped down on as the means of securing the knowledge of Jesus Christ. He sees God in everything and moves towards that end. There is a reckless abandonment about him. His life is tossed to the wind. The Holy Spirit is determined that we shall realize Jesus Christ in every domain of life, and He will bring us back to the same point again and again and again until we do. When you come to a point in life and you recognize Jesus in it, if you make the right choice, you'll move on. If you don't, you'll go full circle again until you do. And I have seen it over and over and over again in my life. Whether it be eating or drinking or washing disciples' feet, whatever it is, we have to take the initiative of realizing that Jesus Christ, Jesus Himself, Jesus the person, is in it. It is not inconsequential. Every phase of our actual life has its counterpart in the life of Jesus. Our Lord realized His relationship to the Father even in the most menial work. He saw God in it. His Father directed it, and God wanted Him to do it. Jesus, knowing that He was come from God and went to God, took a towel and began to wash the disciples' feet. The aim of the spiritual saint is that I may know Him, not that I may do for or the work of God, but rather that you may know Jesus. Do I know Him where I am today, as I am today? If not, I am failing Him. I am here not to realize myself, not to know me, not to love me first and then love others, but to know Jesus. In Christian work, the initiative has to be done and I must do it. That is never the attitude of the spiritual saint. His aim is to secure the realization of Jesus Christ in every set of circumstances he is in. In everything, in all thy ways, in all that you put your hand to, in all that you see about you, in all that is transpiring in your life today. God is in it. God can't help but be there. But there's one thing that you don't know, that we need to learn. And that's what makes you a spiritual Christian. That's what makes you like Jesus. It's when you can see Jesus in it, where you are, as you are, and what you're doing, and you feel God coming out through you to a person, speaking words that you wouldn't even think to say. Guess what? That's what Jesus meant when we become one with him. So yes, the point of it all, the fulfillment of your entire being and life is going to be those moments of every day, all through the day, that you don't walk in the Spirit, but that in that Spirit you know Jesus living in you as you are right now, this moment, today. And if Jesus is in you, don't you think you could hear God speak? I do. I think he's speaking to you right now. Don't you?